Got my new pen from Amazon. And a one-piece pen gasket, Fel-Pro. I'm having some troubles for sure. Okay, so everything fits. Bolt pattern's the same. This has got the I had to put it in my mouth to hold on to it. The bolt pattern's the same. It's left hand dipstick, old style. But the difference between the two pens is the front hoop here where I'm having troubles. Okay, so it works on the stock pen. I'm gonna push it down a little bit for tension. That's good. Yeah. Tight there. And looks like we'll call it a quarter. Sticking up for squish. And the rear is a better fit. Yeah, I guess it's got about the same there. An eighth of an inch, say, poking up. If you push it down on one side, it's poking up an eighth on that side. Now, different story here. The rear's good. But in the area where I'm having troubles, the front, that good 3/8. This is after I've been grinding away here. I'm not sending the sucker back. I'm just gonna make it fit. I get it. Flush the two surfaces so you can see, looks like about an eighth. It was a quarter before. I can get this up here. Hold on to this canvas. Anyways, it looks like about an eighth. I think I'm gonna split the difference. Go 1/16 more. So I have an additional amount of squish. I'm gonna try that first. Because obviously, putting a new gasket in there and on the last one, I couldn't find any area where it was obvious where it was leaking from. That was even black RTV on there too. So let me grind a little bit more there. There. That's about the difference right there. It was What was that, $140? Looks like a decent quality. And my fingerprints all over, but fin base, drain cap on the bottom. It's not magnetic. There's no baffle. Okay, we got a baffle here. I will continue. This is kind of... kind of... winging it. I really don't have any measurements to go by. All I got is the other tank, the other pan to compare to. I take a little bit more off the bottom there. Man. September 27th, everybody's aware of what's going on in the world with North Korea. Pretty scary. It's hard to focus on what you're doing, day-to-day life stuff, without thinking about that guy. Next thing he's gonna do is set off a missile over the Pacific. Hydrogen bomb. If he does that, well, I know what's going to happen. Trump's going to retaliate. Anyways, you just carry on. That's all you can do. I'm right on the coast of the Pacific there, and just on the other side of the line in Canada, and well, the whole world's going to be suffering radioactive material floating around. It's going to go over the whole planet in the jet stream. Well, the jet stream goes east. And right across the line is me and all the boys. I hope the guy keels over from eating too many bonbons. A fat sucker. Maybe it'll send in a SEAL team and bump him off. And hopefully the rest of his regime will go, okay, we're only following orders. Like the Wizard of Oz, as soon as you decapitate the head, the rest go, oh, get down and start bowing. It's, hopefully that's what'll happen. Fuck. Anyways, I'll let you know how this goes. Do a little bit more buffing. Let's try that out. I can almost squish that now. It's actually a good design. It's got a lip going on the inside. And a lip going on the outside. Now, if I can just get this to fit a little better. See, look at the difference. Putting it on the stock pan, it's an eighth of an inch sticking up here. I still gotta. And the tops look like about a heavy eighth, and the bottom's a quarter. So if I can get this down a little bit more on the bottom, I think I'll leave it at that. Keep it a little tight. Do a dry fit first. See if I can bolt it up. Yeah, man. Okay. Let's check it out. Okay, we're good there. That's better. I think I'm gonna go with that. I don't know how it could be so far out. It gave the year on there. I can't remember what it was, but I qualified for that. Mine's a 71, 307. Dipstick on the left side. Everything's the same except for this front ceiling surface. Yeah, it's more parallel now. Cross my fingers. Man, is it ever tight. Look at the clearance between the pan and the head of the bolt. So prepare to sacrifice a socket and grind it down. Same with the 7/16 heads. Just get it in there. What's getting there? What is it? 18 foot-pounds and 8 foot-pounds for the smaller bolts here. Those guys, these are 18. I guess I could sort of get a torque wrench in here. This is not an easy job. These guys, the locating tabs, I struggled getting two of them out. It'd be better to lube up the threads and don't tighten them up. Just get them in there and don't bottom them right out, because you'll be sorry. What have I got here? 1, 2, 3, busted two vice grips to get them out, and it's tight, and then it doesn't turn into a family show anymore. You know what I mean? Okay. I got them all started now. It's a matter of torquing them down. And this was the last one here, and it was tough going. I managed. I'm really happy with my light with the speaker magnet on it. You can stick it anywhere you want. Something like that. Okay. I'll take you for a test run when I got her done. Going for a road test. Another gear vendor's clip, so that's third gear overdrive. Third gear, let's change it into third. Back to third over. I talked to Dave at Gear Vendors. I had a problem with my speedo. I'm waiting for a new gear. My speedometer's out of sync. It's like 10 kilometers over. And I asked about the hard shift. He says, yeah, that's the way they are. The harder the better. Kind of like a shift kit and a transmission. An auto. It's best if they shift really quick and hard. That means there's no slippage in the clutches. I really didn't pick a good time here. I got people following me here. Okay, so we're in fourth over. ...1200 RPM. That's about 80 kilometers, maybe a little bit more than that. Yeah, maybe 85. Feels like it. So it drops about 5. I said 6 in a previous video. It's 5. 500 RPM, it'll drop. Okay, I'll put it on here. Let's see if I can. Fourth gear over. We'll go through the gears. And I've cleaned the all the underside. Everything's spotless down there now. So when I come home, I'll have a good inspection. Good, nobody's coming. Okay. Second. Okay, here, let's go into third. And there's third. Into overdrive, the light comes on here. Hard to do this. There we go. Indicator tells you it's an overdrive. This is a request from Ryan Samuels. Fourth overdrive, roughly about 85K. We're doing 1400 RPM. Into gear the most when you're downshifting, so you're best to be to smoothen it out the best. You're best to have some throttle going on there to smoothen it out, and you can smoothen it out on an upshift if you half clutch. Now, I don't know what it'd be like in an automatic. Probably not quite as harsh. Okay, let's see, let's check out my leaks. Look at that. It's leaking around this drain plug there. Huh. and discovered something here. Look at that. It's my breather for the front diff here is leaking as well. Well, that could have tripped me up. Thinking I had more of a leak than I did. Yeah, it's 90 weight. Gear oil. Well, that's an easy fix. See that? It's really dry up here. Yeah. It's coming up. We're dry. We are dry. Well, there we go. Yeehaw! Okay, well that's fixed. That's fixed at least. That's it. Okay, so that... Actually, I'm gonna check that out. That could be... gear oil right here. Let's have a sniff. No, that looks like fresh oil. Don't like that. Okay, well, more fine tuning. Okay, guys. That's it for me. I'll check this out while I've got the video camera rolling. I bought this roll of hemp rope, 1¼ inches. And I'm gonna do my pillars. I'm tired of looking at this duct tape. UV'd. Duct tape. Doesn't like the sun. 181 feet, would you believe it, just to do that, 73 inches, and man, that's heavy, so I gotta make a big bundle, walk around and around and around, what's that, 82 times, 82 wraps to get to the top. Not looking forward to that. That's going to be hard on the back. All right. Later.